Hello and welcome to Donington Park. With over 30 cars on the grid and over 80 drivers, looks like we're going to be in for some race. But it's going to be hard to top last month's race at Alton Park that had an absolutely fantastic finish. I'm going to hand you over to Chris Hartley now, who's going to talk through all the highlights.
After hosting a dramatic climax to the 2012 Championship, Alton Park hosted the opening round of the new season. And on the evidence of this race, it looks like being the most competitive year yet. Last year's Round 1 winners, JPR Slokes, led the early phase, but their chances of finishing on the podium fell by the wayside, thanks to two stop-go penalties. Team Honeywell suffered contact with a bat marker and had to replace a punctured tyre. But having dropped to 8th place, the 2011 champions fought back. This move around the outside of Nimbus Data Racing put Honeywell into the lead during the closing stages, but it was short-lived as Nimbus dug deep and snatched the place straight back. Having led most of the event, reigning champions Race Logic dropped back to 5th during the last round of pit stops, but in the final laps, Julian Thomas carved his way back up the order before this move on Nimbus put Race Logic back into the lead with just a couple of minutes to spare. They went on to take the chequered flag, the opening victory of the season, and the early championship lead from Nimbus and Honeywell. Team OBR missed out on the podium by just a few tenths of a second at Alton Park, but they won here at Donington last year and are very much a team on the up.
We're working hard on getting the team working as a unit. We're spending a lot more time on getting the car set up right. We feel that the car's handling extremely well now. Like most teams, we don't think we've got the strongest engine out there, but we've got the car really nicely balanced and it's handling very, very sweetly. I mean, take example here today, down the Craner curves, you know, it feels like we're as quick as anything down there. It's really flying on rails down there, very, very nice. So if we can do that, and you know the way this works, if we can be putting in extremely sort of consistent, close to the pace times, you're always in the shout, aren't you?
Team OBR are now running a second car for newcomers, one of which is Graham Pattle's son, Tom.
It's really no expectations. All three of us in the car are novices, and really whatever happens, and a decent finish wherever down the grid it is, we'll be happy with, I think.
Another driver making his Fun Cup debut this weekend is Legends racer at Richard Pocklington. He joins John Tomlinson and Ollie Vine at JPR Wacky Racers for his first taste of endurance racing.
Yeah, we're going really well. I've joined the team today for this round, and we've had the pace. It's been quite good to start with in practice, but we're hoping just to work on a race pace and keep that up to the speed. So far, so good.
I think as we progress, we're hoping to get into the top 10 finishing at least. Then as we go on, if we have solid races, I think we can get close to the top 5, I think, yeah. Yeah. I think winning's maybe a bit too far for us in this season, but it's our first year.
There's a welcome return to Fun Cup for experienced GT and sports car racer Lee Atkins and Hill Speed team boss Ian Moore. On and off, the pair have been racing together since 2006.
We met Racing Radicals. I was doing SR4, Lee was doing SR8. And then we got together to race in Fun Cup in 2009 and 2010. I've had a little bit of a layoff for a few years and come back to getting to racing again.
Yeah, it's great to be back actually, because they've got the new sequential gearbox, which we didn't race last year, so we haven't experienced it. And it's fantastic development. It's a really proper race car now.
It's a double header this weekend, which gives teams two chances to score championship points.
We've got a 1-hour race today, which is different to usual. It's a sprint race, but also a 4-hour race. So it's brilliant to have so much time in a car. We just want to finish both of them. Our team is called Unfinished Business, but on the printout it says unfinished each time, so we want to finish, that's what it is.
Now today we've got not one, but two races for your enjoyment. A busy day ahead then, so let's have a look at the highlights from race one. Your commentator is Chris Hartley.
The grid then drawn by Ballot and Team OBR, Team Honeywell, Nimbus Data and Eco Racing, four of the front runners in the championship, all happen to be at the front of the grid. Team OBR XCAT and Hillspeed on row three, Global Racing and TWA, and then Jolly Roger and Track Focus complete the top 10 ahead of this 60-minute race. On board then with Team Honeywell from the front row of the grid, ready for the rolling start here at Donington Park. To the right of them, to the left of your screen, that's Team OBR. Away we go. And Eco Racing pulling out then around the outside here. And it looks like the car, the silver and green machine, is going to get the lead of the race here. Tom Mills around the outside, through into the lead of the race he goes. Then it's Team O'Brien. Then I think it's Nimbus going through in third. On board with Team Honeywell, they ran wide. They lost another place there to the blue and white Global Racing car. So they're down then to fourth place at least, maybe fifth. One car there just running wide through the gravel, but everybody else escapes through Redgate, through Hollywood, and down now through the Crane of Curves for the first time. And there you can see it is Tom Mills leading the way for Eco Racing. Then it's the 207 Team O'Brien car with Graham Pattle behind the wheel in this first session. And then it's Nimbus Data with Steve Johansson there in third place, the car which almost won at Alton Park, finished a very close second in the end. On board with Team Honeywell, they are in fifth place, chasing down the Global Racing car, squeezing at the inside here, and through he goes. So the 107 Team Honeywell car, Jeff Forsett through to fourth place, and look ahead as they climb up towards Coppice now. They're three abreast, and Nimbus have gone through into the lead. Eco Racing drop down to second position, and third still then we've got the Team O'Brien car. And look there, right at the back of the field, half a lap behind everybody else. That's the team that should have started fifth on the grid, the O'Brien XCAT car. Rob Thomas then a delayed start for whatever reason is at the inside into the chicane at the end of lap one. A great move there from Jeff Forsett to go from fourth to second in the blink of an eye. So it's all change at the end of lap number one. It's Steve Johansson that leads the way for Nimbus Data Racing. Then it's Team Honeywell. Then it's O'Brien in third. Eco have dropped back to fourth place, having got the lead of the race very early on. It's four abreast then in the battle for fifth place, and the green Porsche Byfleet car slings one up the inside and gets through. So that's Scott Kavanagh with a good move then to get up into fifth place. A bit wide there for one or two cars. Team Tiger, the orange car, the 22 O'Brien car, almost going into the gravel, but they escape, they make it through. Looking back now from car number one, JPR Race Logic picking up a place there, moving ahead of the Team McDonald's car on the run down through the Crane of Curves. There you can see the blue number one car starting from the very back of the field. Nigel Greensall, sports car racer, hugely experienced, he's behind the wheel for this first session, and he's already on the attack. Building up a lead at the head of the field there is the blue and white Nimbus Data car, car number 263, driven in this first stint by Steve Johansson. Chasing him down though, look at the Team Honeywell car now having a go to try and get second place. They're wheel to wheel on the brakes, turn right, turn left through the chicane, and hanging on to the position just about is the Team O'Brien car. Graham Pattle holds the place. They're coming up to lap the black and red XCAT car. Looking back now from the Race Logic machine, and they're very late on the brakes into the S's, the chicane at the end of the lap, and CCS Media there picking up a place, moving ahead of Ahmed Khan in the number 88 black JPR run car. So that in the CCS car was Ciro Carinanti with a good move. Good battles going on further down the order. Track Focus picking up a place around the outside of the orange JPR Wacky Racers car. Now we're going to get a replay of the start. Look to the right hand side of the screen in the green and silver car, Eco Racing. Tom Mills with a perfectly judged rolling start there, had that bit more momentum over the start finish line and got into the lead of the race. Another replay of the start on board Team Honeywell, and what a fantastic getaway that was by Tom Mills. Sadly though, he dropped back to fourth at the end of the opening lap. Now there is the number one car of Nigel Greensall, the championship leaders, the defending champions, and he's right on the tail of the triple one Jolly Roger car, driven by Mark Jaffrey, and the Australian has to concede a place there. The British driver Nigel Greensall coming through, he's got the better run coming onto the straight. There he goes on the way into Redgate corner, another place gained, and he's halfway up the order already in the opening stages of this 60-minute race. Next target for him will be Team Tiger. Looking back from the car now as he runs down through the Crane of Curves, absolutely flat out down through this part of the course in top gear. And yes, he gains another place. He's gained one already through Hollywood. He gains another one ahead of Track Focused. Huge amount of speed carrying into the old hairpin and pulling away from the Track Focus car already, as up front the gap reduces. There's now less than a car length between the top two. What's this, a replay? This is Nightingale Racing getting sideways, the car driven by some newcomers in this first race who opted to start at the back of the grid, but they survive as another place is now gained by the onboard camera car of Nigel Greensall, getting ahead of the 2-1-3 machine, another newcomer team this year, Team Holden Racing. Jay Shepherd trying to come back at him, and the Global Racing car then delaying Nigel Greensall, and then he got repassed on the way down the straight. So that was all very close, and this is even closer here. The Porsche Bi-Fleet car, the green machine, running absolutely wheel-to-wheel with the white number 99 JPR Slokes car of Scott Fitzgerald. Look at back for fifth place. Who's got it? It's Fitzgerald who's got through, but he runs wide now. And Scott Kavanagh on the way out of the old hairpin gets the better run, gets better traction, and gets up into fifth place. There's the Redbug Racing car, driven by Andrew Oldham, trying to catch up with Richard Dent in the 170 MLC machine. The blue car there, one of the newcomers to the championship. And into the pits comes 109, Rybridge, Daniel Coyle out of the car. And that's an unscheduled stop. And what's going on further back there, coming out of the chicane, running absolutely to the edge of the circuit and beyond. That was Scott Fitzgerald, very, very wide, almost into the barriers. He's dropped right back from the Porsche Bi-Fleet car now, and he's about to come under attack from Lee Atkins in the Hill Speed Machine. Lee slings one down the inside. The place is his. Nothing Scott can do about it, or is there? No, he keeps his foot in around the outside. That was brave, and stays ahead of Lee Atkins. Looking back now from Race Logic and moving ahead of Tom Mills in the number 61 Eco Racing car. They both move ahead of the 169 Team Cat driver car, which is run at the moment by Phil Marsh behind the wheel, another of our newcomers. And now look at this, Redbug Racing. Andrew Oldham with the move, gets up the inside of Richard Dentzer. Good piece of outbreaking that on the way into the chicane at the end of the lap. Now coming into the pits, this is the Global Racing car, which caused everybody to queue up behind it, and that looks like a front right puncture. So Global Racing, which ran at the front of the field on the opening few laps, it looks like they're going to be delayed by that. Team Honeywell then on board with them in third place, closing up now to the two leaders, and the leader gets very wide, gets the back end out of shape, and Nimbus Data and Team O'Brien about to be overtaken by Jeff Fawcett in the Honeywell car. There's damage to the front left splitter of Chira Karananti's CCS Media car. On board with Team Honeywell, now in the lead then, coming out of the pits, the JPR Wacky Racers car through into Redgate, there into the lead of the race. Nimbus Data down to second, Team O'Brien down to third position. And the other Team O'Brien car there looks like it's just had a spin or a problem. It's got a puncture, it's got a flat tire in the left rear corner of the car. There's number 62 running well, TWM Racing, their first season of Fun Cup. And Purple Apple also challenging for a top 10 as we head for a break. Welcome back to round two of the Fun Cup Championship here at Donington Park. This is the battle for the lead of the race. The red team Honeywell car have just got the lead, but Nimbus Data and Steve Johansson trying to get it back. On board with Honeywell, the place conceded. They're not going to fight too hard in the early stages of the race. Giving Steve just enough room to get through. There was Jeff Fawcett. Still then you've got Graham Pattle in the Team OBR car in third spot, the team which won this race last year. Cars now starting to come into the pits for the first mandatory pit stop of the race. There'll be a further one a little later into this 60-minute Enduro. And coming up well into the top five now, that's Nigel Greensall from the very back of the grid in the championship leading car of Race Logic. On board with Honeywell then, and ahead the race leaders, and they're both peeling into the pits at the same time. So too are Team O'Brien. So you've got the top three all coming in for their mandatory pit stop at exactly the same time. They're peeling off to their pit box on Nimbus, the blue and white car. What's this? A screech of tyres, a spin for the 170 car. And that's the MLC machine in strife into the gravel trap and buried deep. So that's going to be a lengthy delay. Back to the pit stops. And there's the Nimbus Data car coming out. It's going to get back out ahead of the red and white O'Brien car. Will it get out ahead of Honeywell? No is the answer, Team Honeywell. Very, very slick at their pit stops. Nimbus, though, just as quick as them. Or almost as quick as them. Nimbus just conceding a place there. So they switch around. Honeywell getting the lead of the race during the pit stop window. Nimbus almost matching them, but not quite. And then Team O'Brien still running well there in third place. Dragged out of the gravel trap, Richard Dent's MLC machine, but it should be able to get going once again. Thanks to the fast work of the volunteer marshals. There in the garage is the Team O'Brien number 22 machine, which Tom Pattle had the puncture and the car, and obviously more damage to that car. So that's going to be a lengthy pit visit. Oh, all over the grass there goes the Eco Racing car. That is going to seriously slow them climbing uphill now through Schwantz Curve. Race Logic just behind them. Wheel to wheel just behind that battle. Is this one as, again, Porsche Bi-Fleet get up the inside of the white JPR Slokes car. They've been at it wheel to wheel for a while now, and JPR Race Logic swoop past the Eco Racing car, which lost all of its momentum on the run out of the old hairpin. On board, meanwhile, with Team Honeywell, and they are about to lose the lead of the race once again to Nimbus Data Racing. Two different drivers, but the same outcome, a great battle. Bram de Groot then now behind the wheel of the new race-leading car, Nimbus Data. Steve Johansson having done the first stint into the pit stops now. This is the 169 Cat Driver training team. Right behind them, another pit stop, a race between the pit crews, between them and the O'Brien X-Cat team. There's Julian Thomas waiting to get into the race logic car. In comes the car which leads the race, 263, and he might be the team leader, but there's no graceful exit to the car for Bram de Groot. The team just get him out of the way as quickly as possible. There's Mark Burton looking to get in for the final stint in the team O'Brien car. And also a rather ungraceful exit to the car for Global Racing. No marks for style for John Gilbert there. Right, back out on track goes the Nimbus Data car. Steve Johansson back behind the wheel. But is he going to hold the lead of the race? That's the JPR Wacky Racers car, which has stopped out at Coppy's Corner, I think. And there you've got Jolly Roger Racing, 257, coming under attack now from the Porsche Bi-Fleet car. They go past the stricken orange machine of JPR Wacky Racers. So good battle there on the fringes of the top six. Right, now in come Team O'Brien. So of the top three, Nimbus Data have already been in. Coming in now at the end of the pit stop window are O'Brien and on board with Team Honeywell, the other team battling for the lead of the race. So they come in. Tim Wilden's work is done. He will now hand over to team regular Neil Plimmer. It's going to be a race between the pit crews once again. A little bump start there for the Team O'Brien car as Mark Burton is released onto the circuit. There's the Honeywell car still stationary. And Jeff Fawcett waiting to give the signal to Neil Plimmer, but he gets out behind O'Brien. Question is, are they going to both get out in front of the Nimbus Data Racing car or behind it? We'll find out pretty soon. O'Brien go through. Certainly they're ahead of Honeywell. So they're either going to be first and second or second and third, depending on where they've worked into the track with the Nimbus Data car. There's the answer. He's third. So Steve Johansson, third, loses the lead of the race. O'Brien up front. We're heading into the closing laps of what's been a scintillating race. Like they're flying people in to come and watch it. So good is the action here at Donington Park. There is the battle for the lead of the race. The white 207 Team O'Brien car working its way through the traffic. Team Honeywell right behind. So it's Mark Burton in the lead. They're trying to lap the 103 unfinished business car, driven at the moment by Nick Sutton. But that car has been driven very quickly. It's just as quick as the leaders. And they're struggling to get by. And the Team O'Brien car still can't find a way past. It's going to delay Mark Burton down through the crane of curves and on board with Team Honeywell as they squeeze into the lead of the race right at the end here at Donington Park. And now for good measure, Neil Plimmer gets down the inside of the back marker, the very quick back marker I might add, and the contact further back. Scott Kavanagh in the green Porsche Bi-Fleet car making contact with the yellow Greg Edwards driven Kinetics Club car. Scott is busy trying to get through the traffic because right on his tail look, the black, white and red Jolly Roger Racing car in the battle for what's going to be fifth position. There's number 99, slip back a bit now, the JPR Slokes car. Scott Fitzgerald, Steve Harris and Neil Primrose sharing the driving duties. And there's Eco Racing. Doesn't look like they're going to get a podium, but they are going to pick up some points here for another top 10 finish for the team. And they're not quite as competitive yet as they'd like to be. There is Jochen Ritter with his new hairstyle and Nigel Greensaw looking at the timings. And there's their man in the car now for the final stint, Julian Thomas. He's fourth, but I don't think he's quite going to have enough time to catch up with the leaders because the checkered flag is going to be coming out soon. There is the race leading car. Honeywell's pulled away. What about second? Because Team O'Brien now coming under attack from Steve Johansson. The two white machines absolutely wheel to wheel. The O'Brien car's got the inside line for Redgate Corner. Steve Johansson, the racing instructor though, goes around the outside with a brave and determined move. Look, Nick Sutton in the black car still with them. So we're almost home and dry now. Team Honeywell looking for their first victory of the year, and it comes here at Donington Park. They win the race, and then second place is going to go to Nimbus Data. Third place is going to go, in their first podium of the year, to Team O'Brien. Well, the Fun Cup Championship producing yet another quality race here at Donington Park. Here's confirmation of the results with Honeywell, Nimbus Data Racing and Team OBR all making the podium. Championship leaders Race Logic finished fourth with Porsche Bi-Fleet and Jolly Roger completing the top six.
Fantastic pit stops by the team in those two pit stops to get us out there to win that race. Fantastic result for Team Honeywell and Lochinvar. Great teamwork and just great, another great Fun Cup race.
Having won the previous race, championship rules state that Team Honeywell would have to start the next event from the very back. And with the rest of the grid drawn by ballot, it gave some other teams a chance to hit the front. The black 103 car of JPR and Finnish Business led them away from pole, but the white-purple Apple machine snatched the lead under braking into the first corner. The pair then ran wheel-to-wheel down the Crane of Curves for the first time, with Unfinished Business squeezing back into the lead. This was the beginnings of what would turn out to be a prolonged battle during the opening stint. Like Honeywell, Team OBR and Nimbus Data Racing were busy trying to make progress from a lowly grid position. No sooner was the race underway than the Donington Park Marshals were called into action as the blue CCS media car and the orange Team Tiger machine made contact at the chicane. Team Tiger came off worse, suffering a long delay while it had to be hauled out of the gravel trap. Also in the gravel, TWM Racing following this high-speed spin at the old hairpin. Meanwhile, Eco Racing Jolly Roger, JPR Kinetics Club and Global Racing caught the two leaders, giving us a five-car battle at the head of the field. And catching them fast was the Race Logic car, Nigel Greensall having risen from 29th on the grid. In fact, there were some tight battles right the way down the order, Redbug Racing and the 22 Team OBR car becoming close acquaintances at the chicane. Having had a disaster at the start of race one, the other car running under the Team OBR umbrella, Scuderia XCAT, made good progress up to eighth at the end of the first hour. Jolly Roger hit the front at mid-distance, but there was plenty of pressure from Race Logic and the two came together at the chicane. Jolly Roger would then go on to lose even more time with a stop-go penalty for a separate incident. Meanwhile, JPR Slopes and Honeywell were enjoying some great wheel-to-wheel dices on the fringes of the top six, while their closest championship rivals, Race Logic and Nimbus Data, battled it out for the lead. Sadly though, Nimbus dropped out of the race with a brake issue. Not that this gave Race Logic any room to breathe, because during the closing stages, they still had Team OBR to try and fend off. Nigel Greensall and Graham Paddle inseparable after almost 4 hours of racing. Honeywell ran third, the green Porsche bi-fleet car then moved up to fourth after a screech of tyres signalled a dramatic exit to the race for Jolly Roger on the exit to the old hairpin. Thankfully, Ben Gill came to a safe halt after the car suffered a collapsed rear suspension following what presumably was some contact earlier in the race. Last year's diesel class champions Eco Racing are still struggling with the dry setup of their new car, but fifth place gave the team more solid points. JPR Slopes finished sixth, just ahead of Nightingale Racing in seventh, the team's highest ever finish since joining the Fun Cup in 2007. Track Focus finished on the same lap in eighth place, while Global Racing came home in ninth, and the 195 car of Track Cars for Hire enjoyed their best result of the season so far in 10th place. Meanwhile, Team OBR continued to press Race Logic all the way to the chequered flag, but ultimately the defending champions held on to take their second win of the season, Honeywell completing the podium. A look at the championship table shows us that after three rounds, Race Logic remain at the head of the table, just 9 points clear of Honeywell, with Team OBR moving up to third.
It was just brilliant. Yeah, dicing with Graham at the end was just fantastic. It really was. One of those races where it doesn't really matter whether you're first or second, you just have so much fun battling with a real professional.
Two fantastic rounds here at Donington Park today, with the last race, a four-hour endurance race, separating the first two drivers at only 0.3 of a second. Let's hope the excitement can continue at the next race down at Snetterton.
Congratulations then to today's two race winners, to Neil Plimmer, Jeff Fawcett and Tim Wilden, victorious for Team Honeywell in race one. And of course, the Jochen Ritter, Nigel Greensall and Julian Thomas, winners of race two for Team JPR Race Logic. Well done, Team TWM. A very solid drive to 12th in race one, giving the squad of newcomers the Pat Gorman Pies Team of the Race Award. And for their outstanding drive to 7th place, Nightingale Racing are voted winners of the Pat Gorman Pies Team of the Race for race two. Join us again soon for more Fun Cup.